Okay, so my free hand got a little free. So I think what I'm going to do to neaten this up a little bit is tuck this under the layers of the floor. And I've got some extra of the flooring that I cut off, and I should be able to make an insert just to slide under the flooring and maybe tuck under this kick plate here. So we're gonna see if we can get that together, and fingers crossed. Okay, next step. I made a template, sort of, for the section over here that's gonna cover up the carpet and hopefully make this thing a little more neat. So I'm tracing on the back side of the sheeting. And hopefully I've got this placed properly. This way, and we're gonna do a little extra to tuck under, and that leaves the factory straight edge so that I don't have to do freehand freestyle cutting, which didn't work out so well on my first attempt. Doesn't matter what the other side looks like because it's going to be tucked up under the floor. Oh, and I opted for scissors this time because it's more controlled than the Stanley knife. out of the way. Move our tools. And then do dry fit. I think that's gonna fit under there, but do a slight adjustment here. This is in frame. I'm trying to fit it around the base of the seat belt here without cutting the seat belt. Gonna live dangerously. Let me use the stamp knife. Okay, not perfect, but it's definitely better than it was. Took that point in. All right. That is much better. Like I said, I'm not aiming for perfect, I'm aiming for functional. And this is definitely functional. Yay!